everyone, Pro Tipster Paddy here with...
Hello.
Pro Tipster Dan.
Hi there.
So today we wanted to do a video that's a bit different from what we normally do. Normally we'd be talking about upcoming matches or previous matches or strategies on our usual podcast. So, but today we want to talk about something that isn't covered, that isn't covered a lot by tipping platforms, and that's fixed matches. And just pause the video for a second, go to Twitter and search fixed matches and just see at the amount and have a look at the amount of people who are selling these supposed fixed matches. Something that you can read a lot on it, but there's not a lot of videos about. So we said we'd do a video and talk about it for a bit. So Dan, fixed matches, there's a lot of people making a lot of money off of these.
Yeah, but none of them are betting on
No.
It is, even if a game's fixed, it's incredibly difficult to be 100% accurate with fixed matches, which is what, if you Google fixed matches, is what most people kind of promise.
Mm.
They'll tell you, oh, we don't give anything away for free. You have to email or use a WhatsApp number or Telegram to contact someone, and they'll want money by, in the best cases, someone like Nutella or Skrill. In the worst cases, Western Union.
Yeah.
So you've got no guarantee that it's going to work ahead of buying it. And if it doesn't work, you've probably got no way of getting any money back.
Mm.
And these people don't give it away for nothing. That these people do want lots of money from you.
Yeah. And especially, and like, usually what will happen is then they'll start you off with something. Let's say it's, to make it easy to explain it, let's say they give you a tip for an over 2.5 or under 2.5. So that means, you know, they have a 50% chance of being correct if there's going to be more than 2.5 goals or less than 2.5 goals. And this hasn't anything to do with odds, but just based on being right or wrong, you know, you have a 50% chance. So what they'll do is they will put like a post on Facebook or Twitter, and they'll say, I have a fixed match. I have info on a fixed match, who wants in. And, you know, let's say 100 people get back in touch, say, yeah, we want part of that. And what the fixer will do then, he will give, you know, half of the people that respond an underbet. He'll give the other half the overbet. And whatever happens then, he's going to have another 50 people after the result who come back to him looking for a next fixed result. And he'll just rinse and repeat this. But every time doing so, he'll up the stakes. So the first match, he might ask for €100. The next match, €500. Then 1,000, and so on and so on and so on. And this is just with an easy example. Usually it's stuff like, you know, a halftime draw, home win, halftime draw, away win, or away team wins the first half, and then the home team wins the second half, because those odds are really, really big. But for stuff like that, he'd have to have nine combinations. He'd have to have a lot of people. So you understand what I'm getting at here. Just stay away from them, you know.
The thing to remember is that if you look at big Premier League games, for instance, Manchester United against Arsenal, as just to pull a game out of thin air, there is no way that game would be fixed, because to fix a match, you have to pay off players, referees, and Premier League players earn a lot of money, and it's going to make money, the fixer has got to be able to take more money in than he would pay to fix the game. Obviously, they would look to put money on themselves, but this is why bookmakers, they monitor suspicious betting patterns. It's easier to fix a game in a lower level, where you've got players who earn little to no money, where you've got referees who earn little to no money, to give them a little bit extra.
Mm.
But the problem with that is that so few people bet on those matches. If a rash of people go onto a bookmaker and bet on a team to win at 3, 3.5, 4, then the bookmaker is going to think there's something up here, suspend the market, and call in, you know, the feds, as it were.
Mm-hmm.
And it's that inherent in legality which makes trying to get fixed matches just an insane proposition, because the only example I can give is like buying drugs. You know that MDMA, you know that cocaine, you know that speed, amphetamine, they work and they're going to get you high. But because drugs are illegal, you don't know if you're getting a pure substance ahead of buying it, And it could be cut with something like brick dust, rat poison, or whatever. So your point, you're always risking yourself, and the person selling it is risking nothing. It's exactly the same with fixed games, because they're going to ask you to pay by an untrackable method, such as Western Union. They're going to ask you for a lot of money, and if it doesn't win, and in all probability it won't, they're the ones laughing with your money, and you're left even broker.
Yeah. Another thing to remember as well is that if someone is selling you this fixed tip for, they usually go for like 100 euros. If they're selling it for 100 euros, you got to ask yourself, why is this guy selling it for 100 euros when he could just put that 100 euros on the tip himself? Or come on, if you knew a fixed match, would you tell anyone? No, you wouldn't. You'd bet your mortgage on it, but you'd never tell a soul.
Well, there's another sport that is rife for this is horse racing. And horse racing, again, the old standard was that the jockey would get the nod to try or not to try. And it would depend on how the market had gone, the betting market. And if the betting market had gone high enough and people had piled in, then they'd say, yeah, okay, you know, give the horse his best shot. But all it would take is too many people to get into it.
Yeah.
The market's come down and they're like, nah, it's not worth it.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's exactly the same with fixed betting. The more people that are betting on it, bookmakers work on mathematical odds. They don't work on they start with the likelihood of something happening, but from there they take it with mathematical odds.
Mm.
Another good example is Next Manager. You'll see a manager's price drop drastically, but it's because someone's put 50 quid on the manager, and there's no liquidity in the market. Yeah. Liquidity is how much money is on each of the people in the market. So if you've got a Turkish third division game and there's only £20 in total staked with that game, with one bookmaker, and you try and wade in with 200 euros, and think about it, if you've already spent 100 euros on this fixed tip, you need to win at least 100 euros profit to make a profit. Then the bookmaker's going to go, nah, not taking it.
Yeah.
And you're out. You're out of pocket.
Your account is closed. You might get reported. You know, it's just too dodgy. No, look, we're not saying it doesn't happen. Fixed things in games definitely happen. We know that for sure. There's been big investigations over the last couple of years. People have been found out. There was a German referee who was in trouble. There was Delroy Fassi, how I'm saying his name. He was charged with being a middleman between a Singapore syndicate and players. So it does happen, but a fixed game, what's more likely is something like who'll be shown a yellow card, who will get the first corner, first throw in. What do you call it? Spot fixing. So that's far more likely than like a result. Like you can't seriously expect, you know, like Barcelona and Real, you know, some kid in his basement in Glasgow has information that the Barcelona are going to beat Real Madrid 3-1. I mean, it's ludicrous, you know. Keep your money and maybe invest it in software to help you learn more about betting or something.
I would say something even further. If you're gambling to try and make money quickly, you're doing it for the wrong reasons, and you shouldn't. We end all our videos with a gamble aware thing, and it's true.
It's true.
It's absolutely true. If you're trying to make money from gambling because you need money quickly, yeah, you're doing it for the wrong reasons, and you're on the path to ruin.
Yeah.
I'll guarantee you that.
Yeah. It's simple. When the fun stops, stop. You know, and there's loads of help out there. If you need it, do get it, because it can ruin lives. But there is stuff as well I wanted to mention. If you think you've been to a match and you've seen a fixed game, UEFA have an app you can get for Android and iOS. It's called UEFA Integrity, and they take this stuff very seriously. The company Sports Radar, they track games as well. There's a very good BBC article about it, and they reckon match fixing goes on and it happens in 1% of all the games. So, it's pretty minuscule. And they can very easily track, like what Dan was saying, they can very easily track how it's done, because they'll see odds just crash down very quickly. And they can also track managers' players involved, things like that. And there was, in the article, they said there was one manager who changed club four or five times, and very similar patterns were following him in games he was involved in. So, yeah, seriously, like some kid in Lithuania who wants money from Western Union, he doesn't know. He's just ripping you off. So stay away from these. Just stay away from them, you know. And that's that, Dan.
Please don't ask us for fixed games, because us saying go away generally tends to offend.
Yeah, we do get messages on our Facebook page for fixed games. So we don't have them. We'll never have them. We don't want them. No, stay away from fixed games, because fixed games happen. But when they do happen, the general public like us, we're not learning about them. There's no way. So stay away from them. And, spend more time on Pro Tipster and you'll learn more about betting there. Okay? That's pretty much it, Dan, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Alright, so look, like I said, go and check out Pro Tipster. If you're good at betting on sports, you can earn money with us, because we'll give you money.
And if you're not good, you can learn from us about betting strategies, you can ask us questions, you can contact us on Facebook, Twitter, by email, watch our Facebook Live, and we'll show you what we know and what we do when we try to find winning bets.
All right, that's it then. I'm Pro Tipster Paddy.
I'm Pro Tipster Dan.
Good luck.